About time you came along. I've a special tale to share with you today. Or so I'd like to say, but it is getting rather late. Best spend the night. We can talk again come the morning. Ah, good. You're awake. Look to the sea, my friend. Hard to resist setting out in one's boat with fair skies like these, eh? Now, I've told you about the sunken temple in the middle of the sea, haven't I? I'm quite sure I mentioned it. But I ne'er spoke of the man who resides there. He was such a worthy ruler in life that his armies safeguard him even in death. As he himself would have it, he was once entrusted with the task of watching over this world from the heavens above. Yet he tired of his duty and abandoned his perch in the sky in favor of founding a small kingdom on the ground. Alas, though he was a just and goodly ruler, there is not a single person alive who remembers his name. Ooh, it sounds unfortunate, but if you ask me, 'tis all a matter of perspective. It can be a blessing to forget and to be forgotten. I should know. In all my long years, I've never forgotten a single thing. I remember everything, every little detail. Would that I could forget some of it. A lie it may seem, but a lie it is not. I speak only the truth, as you well know. Come see me again, if it pleases you. I've tales aplenty to share.
Heavens, Fend. I'd ne'er seen the like.
I'd not known there were ruins in the depths of this cavern till the path appeared. 'Twas magic, methinks. I should have liked to investigate if the place hadn't been crawling with monsters. I'll be needing sturdier arms than these afore I head back in there, I fear. At any rate, I'd best report this discovery to my commander. Only pray naught grave shall come of it.
There rather feels like aught's lying in wait for us. But we shan't find out what 'tis unless we press on.
There's no great shock to me.
Mayhap 'twould behoove us to investigate Stormwind Cave. It appears that aught has occurred therein.
I'm not sure what to tell you.
All I say is true.
What an exhausting day it's been.
Can't place what 'tis. No one of us see.
We're going this way now, I suppose. By your will.
'Tis not for us to gainsay the Arisen's judgment. We must go where we are bid.
Fancy a look at my wares? Always a pleasure.
Gathering materials makes for dull work indeed.
This always puts me.
Here we are, in the blink of an eye. Shall we take stock of our surroundings?
Mm-hmm.
But be sure to buy all.
Pray, slow your feet!
Look as long as you please. Have you brought me a quince? Pray, do a man a kindness.
Always a pleasure.
Back Batal is not a friendly place for pawns. Each gaze we encounter feels more unjustly vicious than the last.
Mustn't lose my head.
Given the state of things, I may have to cloak. Was the inn here long? For the future of this nation, sir. Do come again.
Look at my wares.
but be sure to buy aught.
Have you brought me a quince? Many thanks, sir. At last, I may continue reading that grimoire. This could be the turning point in my family's fortune.
Shall we follow, Master?
Whatever's to be done. Pleasant surroundings
make. Perhaps this will seem of little consequence, but the pain I experienced at the coronation was beyond imagining. What baleful art could grant one other than the Arisen control over pawns?
What does this say?
It couldn't hurt to take a peek. Do you know how long you'll be? I only asked so that I might adopt the most effective stance to
I reckon they just remember. You hadn't. No, there's no need to fret.
Ah, that's right. I must fetch those papers. Admirable work.
Today, interested in my wares?
I'm not sure what to do.
Looking for aught in particular?
Go on, have a look.
Me? Now, this hardly bears saying, but don't you dare try to take anything without always a pleasure.
Just tell me what you need, and I'll see it done. You're welcome.
Nothing caught.
Hear this. Last. And what did I find but the most gorgeous shards? Like drops of azure plucked from the sky. Took a few home, I did. Then, as I boasted of my finds at the tavern, a man from the Forbidden Magic Research Lab came up and asked to buy them. I threw out a price. Figured I'd see where we stand and all. Only for him to double it on the spot. Seems the shards are treasures that washed up from the sea floor on occasion. Ears open, I'll find a few more.
A customer, then. That changes things.
Interested in my wares? Hoy, looking to change? No need to overthink it. You can change it on a whim. You've naught to lose, and you might even make a new discovery. Well, got any findings to share? Many thanks.
Oh, I cannot wait to see you.
Greetings, Sir Arisen. I have a message for you. Sir Manella would speak with you in the palace. Pray seek her out at your earliest convenience.
Hoy, looking to change? No need to overthink it. You can change. Change it on a whim. You've naught to lose. And you might even make a new discovery.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Interested in my wares?
Around if you must, but be sure to buy aught.
There's got to be a way to Got to find more places to buy my stuff.
Well met, sir.
How might...
While we're here, shall we...
Given the state of things, I may have... to close the inn ere long. Fear for the future of this nation, sir. Do come again.
Well met.
Dear me. The secret to my monstrous gate. Well met.
Another.
That old history would last a day without me.
Another day over.
Now I've lost the thread of my thoughts.
If you must... Let's go off on your own. There's naught to be done. I only hope you'll return sooner rather than... later.
I suppose all we can do is wait.
I'd sooner stay out of battle.
Where all this work puts a damper on the spirits.
Only person I believe in is myself.
What teachings myself, the people's woes? How might I aid you, sir? Is there aught I can assist you with? I must not be spoken to. I fear I've much to attend to.
Best not be bothering me for no reason. I've got nothing for ye. I've got nothing for ye.
Well met, Sir Arisen. Let us dispense with pleasantries and cut to the heart of the matter. I have a task that requires someone of your skill and discretion. Some days ago, a fiend attacked Empress Nadinia during her supplications. Her Majesty was unharmed, but the would-be assassin fled, gifting me a wounded arm in the process. He may seek to strike again, yet I fear I am not fit to guard the Empress as I am. And so I turn to you, Sir Arisen. Will you catch this villain in my stead? My deepest thanks. Her Majesty will next begin her supplications in Flamebearer Palace. I would use this opportunity to lure her assassin from the shadows. Empress Nadinia's life is in your hands, Sir Arisen. I trust you understand the gravity of this task.
I would appreciate your swift return, Master. A fell unease begins to gnaw at me when you are gone over long.
I suppose all we can do is wait.
Follow me if you would. I know the path best travelled.
Well, if you insist. I'm only glad I don't have to lead the way for a change. this a challenge, Arisen, to see who can keep pace?
No time to catch your breath. Try to keep up. Tal's Empress has clearly earned the love and respect of her subjects.
Almost wish Orc would happen to shake things up.
We shall wait here till your business is done.
Mind yourself. Irreverence shan't be tolerated here. I must not be spoken.
Empress Nadinia's life is in your hands, Sir Arisen. Empress Nadinia's life is in your hands, Sir Arisen. You must ensure her.
We presume that Lord Phasus may be found in his laboratory, a facility conducting research into forbidden magics. I must not be spoken. We presume that Lord Phasus may be found in his laboratory, a facility conducting research into forbidden magics.
Okay. Another moment. I've got nothing for ye. Empress Nadinia's life is in. Empress Nadinia's life is in your.
A moment's prayer can do.
Empress Nadinia's life.
Nothing wrong with filching for survival.
Today's
horse. Maybe if I hang about. Someone's quiet.
Empress Nadinia's life is...
I must burn.
I have been waiting for you, Arisen.
Empress Nadinia's life...
I fear I've much to attend to.
Empress Nadinia's life... Empress Nadinia's life is in your hands, sir. Empress Nadinia's...
No fear, Master. I'll fare all right without you for a little while.
'Tis not our place to hurry the Arisen.
Mind yourself. Irreverence shan't be tolerated here. I fear I've much to attend to.
Empress Nadinia's life is in...
World's changing. Not sure how much longer I can keep the inn open.
I have no issue falling asleep, even at this.
I can't tell you how I suffered at the hands of...
Our adventure continues.
Off we go then.
Ready to forge on? We shall remain here.
And who might?
Sir Arisen, you've come just in time. Sir Ermhild, tis my pleasure to present to you the good Arisen, come to aid us in apprehending the brigand who would threaten Her Majesty's life.
Well met. Your assistance is most welcome. Without our Empress to guide us, Batal has no future. Her Majesty cannot be allowed to come to harm.
Indeed. We are well glad of your aid. May it prove unnecessary. Ere Her Majesty's supplications begin, I shall give you a description of our target. Pray seize the rogue should you espy him. We would, however, prefer that this affair be kept quiet. Be not reckless in your decision, lest you apprehend the innocent. Empress Nadinia shall commence her prayers any moment now. I would ask that you safeguard her with your life, should it come to that.
O lambent flame, we offer thee these words of prayer on behalf of our people.
What am I supposed to do about it?
Someone will buy aught.
We ask that all be spared the horrors of the fell dragon. We ask that Batal may e'er prosper. And we ask that a day may come when Beastron, human, pawn, and every other noble race.
Who are ye supposed to be? Fie! Are they onto me? Ah, shod it!
Apprehend him at once. That man there is the assassin. Nicely done, Sir Arisen. Let us inform Sir Ermhild of what has transpired.
Oh, Your Majesty. Full glad am I to see you unharmed.
The brigand has been captured. The chaos of the past few days ought to be behind us now. We owe this outcome to you, Sir Arisen. You cannot know the depth of my gratitude.
Ah, yes, of course. Batal is in your debt, Sir Arisen. The same is true of you, Sir Manella. Your efforts were most admirable, considering your wound. Now that a measure of peace is returned to us, however, you ought to devote yourself to convalescence for a time. You may. The curative hot springs on Volcanic Island are said to be wondrous for healing. Go there to recuperate.
Very well, my lady. I shall leave presently, and return when I am fully recovered.
Grateful are we for your most valiant efforts, Sir Arisen.
Thank you, Sir Arisen. Truly.
This bodes ill.
I'm about ready to fall asleep on my feet.
I've got to focus.
It isn't easy shifting only pantry just locked these days.
Something written here.
A thorough perusal might reveal aught of interest.
Methinks I know where that individual is to be found. Leave this to me, Master. I'll bring you straight to the one you seek.
Freshly rested as we are, this battle ought to be in our favor.
Try not to get hit, unless all that boom goes away.
Allow me. Wait a moment.
Thank you.
lead the charge!
No sense letting the enemy gain the upper hand. Learn gripping against the worm.
So in step, eh?
You would gather materials here, Master. Can we really afford to carry more? If I might be so bold as to speak my mind, the private quarters of one Arisen I served had many a visitor, and rarely the same one.
Now there's a thought.
I've got a good feeling about this one. Prevailed by the skin of our teeth.
Thanks, friend. 'Tis just my way of saying thanks.
Staring Arisen, there's aught you... Under caught your eye.
I am attentive and loyal, and prefer to remain by your side. In battle, I shall follow your lead and prioritize support.
I could look upon this sky for all eternity, if 'twasn't for the crick in my neck.
Keep gazing upward and you'll like to stumble ere long.
I'm all for swapping stories, but perhaps another night. I can scarce keep my eyes open.
We'll never get anywhere if all we do is rest.
Let us return once we've grown tired from our labors. I'll gather this. It might be of use. Flame will accomplish little against this foe.
the path.
Seek you passage to the southwest? I'd advised against it, sir. It is a forbidden place. Those who tread near are said to be devoured, you see. I heard one survivor tell of how his companion went suddenly quiet. And when he turned round to see what was wrong with her head fell off and crumbled into dust. You hear a lot of those stories round here. I've met people who've lost arms and legs, or else watched their friends get rent in two so fast they were still crawling as they died. Should you choose to go there in spite of my warning, sir, on your head be it. But I pray you'll return to tell us what you saw. I'd be well eager to learn a bit.
Hope you weren't expecting mercy.
Do not despair. I'm coming to your aid.
Speaking of which, might we not consider bringing a sorcerer into our party?
Their destructive capabilities are a sight to behold. Material. Useful things, these.
Different combinations of materials result in different creations.
It is a pleasure to meet you.
I enjoy tackling fierce foes, and prefer combat's thrills to gathering items. I am pleased to dispense with the formalities.